Here's another near 7-pointer, way down south here, within 24 hours of the 6.9 or 7.0 that California had, 6.8 east of the South Sandwich Islands. You can see where the epicenter is, close to the plate boundary, and this one was shallow too. It was only 9.9 miles deep. Looking at the tsunami page, here's the 7.0 in California. They had three statements yesterday. Then they issued a statement for a 4.5 in Alaska. And now this one that just happened, they issued two statements. The first statement is for the Virgin Islands, Puerto Rico. They're listing it as a 6.8. And they're saying there's a small possibility of a local or regional tsunami that could affect coasts located usually no more than a few hundred kilometers from the earthquake epicenter. And here's a second statement, March 11th, Universal Time. And here's a second statement. They're calling it a 6.8 MAG, 7 miles deep. And this is for the Gulf of Mexico, Puerto Rico, Virgin Islands. And they're saying that there's no tsunami threat. Checking out the National Data Buoy Center. You can see these two buoys that are still going off. That was from yesterday's Ferndale earthquake. And if we look down here, we can see they don't have any buoys stationed down here where this earthquake happened. And if we click on these, you can see that it still shows a couple meter swing. Second one, pretty much the same thing. Maybe the earthquake jolts these buoys and it throws them in this swing mode and then they have to reset them. I don't know for sure. And here's an article about yesterday's earthquake, the 6.8. You can see the epicenter here, shake map colors. And I'll put a link to this down below in the description. They're saying a series of small aftershocks continued to rattle the extreme northern coast of California on Monday, hours after magnitude 6.8 earthquake shook the town of Eureka and an area extending into Oregon and Nevada with no reports of damage. So that's good. But I'm sure a lot of people felt it. They say the main tremor, which struck at about 10:30 p.m. on Sunday, was centered in the Pacific, about 50 miles west of Eureka and 10 miles beneath the ocean floor, according to USGS Geological Survey. That size. I'll put a link to that so you can read the rest of this article. New ozone depleting gas is found in the atmosphere. That's an interesting article here. I'm going to have to read that one. Another volcano going off. And here they're talking about number of earthquakes in Yellowstone National Park. And they have an article here, Yellowstone volcano 2.5 times larger than previously thought. That could be a real mess if that thing finally blows up. And this is on the Extinction Protocol site. I'll put a link to this down below in the description. And here, checking on the ARSO map, I like this, the way they put the daylight and the nighttime feature on it. You go over here, I'm right here. There's some kind of event. The Big Island had an earthquake. It was a 2.8, 35 kilometers deep. That's pretty deep. And its sun is still up here, but you can see where the nighttime is coming. Nighttime on the mainland now. And let's see if, oh yeah, here we go. This is the earthquake that we're checking on right now. And they're calling it a 6.8 magnitude at a depth of 16 kilometers. And looking at the earthquake list, the red ones are usually the larger one. This is a 5.1 of Vanuatu. And then 5.1 of Vanuatu. And then 5.4 Papua New Guinea. 5.4 Papua New Guinea. And now here we have the South Sandwich Islands. They're recording three 6.8, 6.8, and 6.8. Everybody try and have a good evening and have a good day tomorrow. Aloha.